If you're one of those people who's ever looked at a horse and a rider and found their harmonious motion to be absolutely enthralling, then this is the video for you. Today, we're going to talk about how a horse and a human maintain this consistency in their dynamics without actually speaking to each other. Well, there is one physics concept that lies at the heart of this in tandem motion of the two species, that is synchronization. We are going to consider the horse rider system as a coupled dynamical system. The two entities constituting this system have natural dynamics of their own, but when put together, they quickly adjust to each other's rhythms. And the question is, how exactly are they doing it? So let's dive a bit deeper into this motion. The manner in which a horse moves is called a gait. For the majority of this video, we're going to talk about one particular type of horse gait called the rising trot. In order to maintain this gait, the rider ends up adjusting the rate of their up-down movements with the speed of the horse and vice versa. To give you a more visual idea of what is happening, let us slow down this video of a trot sequence and plot the vertical movements of both the back of the horse and the rider's head. The up-down movement or the oscillations of the rider would be to a significant degree captured by the movement of their head, represented by the red curve. Similarly, the bounce of the horse is captured by the vertical movement of his back as marked by the blue curve. Now, in the time that the red curve takes to finish one cycle, the blue curve seems to have completed two cycles. And this keeps happening for as long as the rider and the horse are performing the rising trot. This phenomenon of coordinated motion between two entities is called synchronization. In particular, this horseback and rider ensemble exhibits a 2:1 synchronization. Another thing you might notice here is that one peak in the horseback movement is higher than the other. Pause for a moment and ponder over why this is happening. Okay, so first to answer as to why the horse's back completed two cycles and not one during rising trot, we'll have to look at the movement of the horse's legs. The red color denotes the right front leg and the left hind leg of the horse. As you can see, there are two legs with the red marker and both of them move simultaneously. So, the horse is moving their right front leg with their left hind leg. Similarly, representing the other diagonal pair of legs with the color blue, we can see those two also move simultaneously. Essentially, what we are trying to say is that during rising trot, horse's legs move in diagonal pairs. But if one were to talk about the back of the horse, it moves up as one diagonal pair of legs start their ascent and comes down as the same pair lands back on the ground. Again, during the movement of the other diagonal pair, the back would make another cycle of up and down motion. Hence, a horse's back completes one cycle of up-down motion with the movement of each diagonal pair of legs. A rider, on the other hand, would start rising while one of these diagonal pairs is in motion and would be descending during the movement of the other diagonal pair of legs. So, in time for the first diagonal pair of legs to go in motion again, a rider has finished one complete cycle of going up and coming down. Hence, we can say that in the time a rider completes one up-down movement, the horse's back has completed two such cycles. Also, we believe one of these two horseback movements is smaller because when the rider rises, to a certain extent, they take energy for this vertical movement from the saddle. Therefore, the horseback oscillation is smaller when the rider is rising. We would also like to mention here that synchronization is a dynamical phenomenon in the sense that there is a continuous information transfer from one oscillating entity to the other. For example, the rider here is constantly adapting her rate of vertical movement in order to have a smooth mechanical interaction with the horse. Any mismatch in their frequencies may lead to the rider hitting the horse's back, which is not at all a pleasant experience for either one of them. So if we wish to speed up the trot, then we'll have to give some sensory cue to the horse. Depending on the signal, the horse will speed up or slow down, and the rider would then match their own rate of oscillations with the speed of the horse to be able to continue their rising trot. We must also include here examples of 1:1 synchronization within the same riding framework. For that, let's focus on the movement of one of the horse's legs. Assuming each time one of these legs starts their movement to be the beginning of an oscillation, we'll find these leg oscillations to be well in coordination with the up-down movement or the oscillation of the rider. That is, the leg of the horse completes only one oscillation as defined previously in the time that the rider completes one oscillation. In conclusion, synchronization is the phenomenon where two or more oscillating entities operate in unison owing to some information transfer between them. Our world is full of such synchronized ensembles, be it fireflies firing in unison or the synchronized oscillations of two pendulas hanging from the same support. In fact, why don't you try and find synchronization patterns in other horse gates and let us know what you have explored. We would like to end this video with a big thank you to Josie for letting us use her video for the synchronization analysis. Please go visit her channel Basic Horse Training if you wish to learn more about horse riding.